Let's draw the PF3 Lewis structure. This is phosphorus trifluoride. So the first thing we do with Lewis structures, we count the total number of valence electrons for the molecule. The periodic table, that can help us do that. So if we find phosphorus right here, it's in group 15, sometimes called 5A. It has 5 valence electrons. Fluorine right here, group 17, sometimes called 7A, these elements have 7 valence electrons. We have 3 fluorine atoms. We multiply by 3, 5 plus 21, 26 total valence electrons for the PF3 Lewis structure. We'll put the least electronegative atom in the center. That's going to be the phosphorus. So we'll put a phosphorus atom and we'll put 3 fluorine atoms around it. Next, we're going to put a pair of electrons between the atoms, and that's going to form the chemical bond. So we'll put a pair of electrons between each fluorine and phosphorus atom. At this point, we've used 6 valence electrons. We have 26. So now we're going to complete the octets on the outside atoms first, on the fluorines. That looks like this. So far, we've used 24 valence electrons. We have 26. So we'll put the last 2, those will go on the inside atom, on the phosphorus. And at this point, each element here, each fluorine, has an octet. The phosphorus in the center, that has an octet. This is the Lewis structure for PF3. If we looked at the molecular geometry for PF3, this lone pair of electrons here, it actually pushes the fluorines down. So we end up with a trigonal pyramidal molecular geometry for PF3. If you need more help with that, there's a link at the end of this video. This is Dr. B with the Lewis structure for PF3, phosphorus trifluoride. Thanks for watching.